नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज हाउ टू करेक्ट द एक्सेस डिमांड यूजिंग द मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी। इन इंडिया आरबीआई मेक्स द मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी कंट्रोल द मनी सप्लाई बाय द आरबीआई। व्हेनेवर द आरबीआई कंट्रोल द मनी सप्लाई दैट इज नोन एज मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी। हियर टू मेजरमेंट वी आर टेकिंग, वन इज क्वांटिटेटिव इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स एंड अनदर इज अ क्वालिटेटिव इंस्ट्रूमेंट। फर्स्ट वी आर डिस्कस यूजिंग द क्वांटिटेटिव इंस्ट्रूमेंट हाउ एक्सेस डिमांड कैन बी रिमूव। द फर्स्ट इज बैंक रेट और अ रेपो रेट। व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ बैंक रेट और रेपो रेट? रेपो रेट इज दैट रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट एट विच आरबीआई गिव्स द लोन टू द कमर्शियल बैंक। नाउ इफ आरबीआई वॉन्ट्स टू करेक्ट द एक्सेस डिमांड then RBI increase the bank rate. If bank rate is increased, then cost of credit is increased. Further, bank also, commercial banks also give at the high rate of interest, then demand for the money is decreased. Second is open market operation. What is the meaning of open market operation? Open market operation means sale and purchase of government securities by RBI. In case of excess demand, RBI offer to the commercial bank for sale. RBI sell the government security and so that money supply reduce in the economy and the problem of excess demand will be removed. Third is increase in legal reserve requirement. In legal reserve requirement, we are taking two types of reserves. One is cash reserve ratio and second is statutory liquidity ratio. What is a cash reserve ratio? Cash reserve ratio is that ratio which is kept with the central bank, which is kept with the central bank of the total demand deposit, and statutory ratio that is kept with the commercial bank. If cash reserve ratio is more, so more of the money is kept in the reserve and less money in the circulation, so the problem of excess demand will be removed. And same as statutory liquidity ratio means it is the total amount which is kept with the commercial bank themselves. When commercial bank themselves kept reserve so that money in the market will be less and the problem of excess demand will be removed. Here bank rate, open market operation and cash reserve ratio and statutory liquidity ratio, using all these quantitative instrument we can correct the excess demand. Now the next is qualitative instrument. What is the meaning of qualitative instrument? Qualitative instrument increase the margin requirement. What is the margin meaning of margin requirement? Margin requirement means the value of the security and the loan taken by on that security. The difference between the value of the security and loan taken by on that security. If RBI wants to remove the excess demand, RBI increase the margin requirement. RBI increase the margin requirement. Suppose the value of security is 1 lakh rupees and RBI gives a loan on that securities is 60,000. The margin is 40,000. If RBI take some more margin, then people takes less loan from the commercial bank and the problem of excess demand will be removed. Second is moral suasion. What is the meaning of moral suasion? Moral suasion means advice to discourage lending. Moral suasion means RBI advice to the commercial bank, because RBI is a lender of last resort. So RBI advised to the commercial bank to lending less money. money to the public. If less money lent to the public, then the problem of excess demand will be removed. And last is selective credit control. Selective credit control means credit rationing. Credit rationing means there are different sectors in the economy. RBI gives the instructions to the commercial bank, you have to give less credit to the commercial bank. There is a fixing of quota to the commercial bank, the productive purpose, unproductive purpose, which areas you have to give more loan and not to be give the loan to the speculative purpose. These are the qualitative instruments. All these instruments we can solve the problem of excess demand. Excess demand problem can also be using the fiscal policy. Now, what is the meaning of fiscal policy? Fiscal policy means when government decide some expenditure and related to income, government makes some policies that is called the fiscal policies. First is decreasing the government expenditure. If there is excess demand in the economy, then government reduce the expenditure. If government reduce the expenditure, then the problem of excess demand will be removed. Second is increase in taxes. Government impose different taxes, direct taxes or indirect tax to the household sector, corporate sector. Different taxes are taken by the government. In case of excess demand, government increase the taxes. If government increase the taxes, then disposable income will be less. And if disposable income will be less, the person will demand of goods and services. Then the problem of excess demand will be removed. Third is increase in public borrowing. Increase in public borrowing means government takes a loan from the public. If government takes more borrowing from the public, then the public disposable income will be less and then public will be buy less commodities so that excess demand problem will be removed. And last is deficit financing. Deficit financing means printing the new currency. It is used for printing the new currency. Whenever there is excess demand in the economy, then RBI avoid deficit financing, avoid the printing the currency. So all these instruments we can solve the problem of excess demand. Now, next topic is how we can correct the deficit demand by the monetary policy and the fiscal policy. Already you know the monetary policy is made by the RBI and fiscal policy is made by the government. In monetary policy, we are taking two types of instrument. One is a qualitative instrument and another is a quantitative instrument. Quantitative instrument, in case of deficit demand, decrease the bank rate. First is a decrease the bank rate. If we want to correct the deficit demand, decrease the bank rate. RBI decrease the bank rate. Bank rate means the rate at which RBI gives the loan to the commercial bank. Here RBI reduce the bank rate so that the cost of credit availability is reduced. If cost of credit availability is reduced, commercial bank takes more loan. Then if commercial bank takes more loan, then public also takes more loan, then the problem of deficit demand will be solved. Second is purchase the securities from open market. In open market operation, the security is purchased by the RBI. In case of deficit demand, RBI purchases the securities. Whenever the RBI purchases the securities, money supply in the market will be increased. If money supply in the market will increase, then the problem of deficit demand will be removed. Third is decrease the CRR. CRR, cash reserve ratio, is that reserve ratio which is kept with the central bank. If this reserve will be reduced, then money supply in the market will be more. If this reserve will be reduced, then money supply in the market will be increased. And if money supply in the market will be increased, then the problem of deficit demand will be removed. Fourth is decrease the SLR. Statutory liquidity ratio is that ratio which is kept with the commercial bank themselves. If commercial bank kept less reserve with themselves, all of the money comes to the market, then aggregate, then the problem of deficit demand will be removed because money supply is increased in the market. These are the quantitative instrument from which we can solve the problem of deficit demand. Second is a qualitative instrument. Qualitative instrument, first is decrease the margin requirement. You know what is a margin requirement? Margin requirement means the value of the security, the difference between the value of the security and the money lending. Here, the difference between the value of the security and the money lending will be less, so that encourage the people to take loan, and people will take the loan, then the problem of deficit demand will be removed. Second is advice to give more loan. It's a moral suasion because RBI is the head of the commercial bank. RBI advised to the commercial bank to give more loan to the public. If commercial banks gives more loan to the public, then the problem of deficit demand will be removed. Third is withdrawal credit rationing. Withdrawal credit rationing means sometimes it is decided in different sectors how much quota is fixed, how much loan is to be provided to the different sector. Here, withdraw the credit rationing. Here, no quota is fixed to the different sector. That is, withdraw every sector takes a loan from the commercial bank. If every sector takes a loan to the commercial bank, then the problem of deficit demand will be removed. These are the instruments, quantitative and the qualitative instrument which is solve the problem of deficit demand. Now, some fiscal instrument which is used by the government, first is increase government expenditure. If there is a less demand in the economy, then what government do? Government will increase the expenditure. If government will increase the expenditure, then the problem of deficit demand will be removed. Second is decrease the taxes. The government impose different type of taxes to the public and the corporate tax. If government decrease the tax, then the disposable income will be increased. And if disposable income will be increased, people demand for goods and services more, then the problem of deficit demand will remove. Decrease from public borrowing. When commercial bank can take a loan from the public, in case of deficit demand, decrease from the public borrowing, it will be take less borrowing from the public. If less borrowing from the public, all of the money, all of the goods and services is by the public from all of the goods are by from the public. So decrease the public borrowing, this problem is also solve our deficit demand problem. And last is deficit financing. Here is deficit financing means printing the new currency. If there is deficit demand in the economy, then new currency, on printing the new currency to solve the problem of deficit demand. So all these instruments we will take the correct of deficit demand. Why we are taking all these instruments? Because excess demand and deficit demand both are harmful for our economy. So we have to correct both excess demand and deficit demand using the monetary policy and the fiscal policy. Next is trade cycle. You know, aggregate demand, whenever the aggregate demand is equal to aggregate supply at full employment level, here resources are fully utilized. This is a right situation in the economy, but it is not possible at every time in the economy aggregate demand is equal to aggregate supply. There is so natural changes in the economy, sometimes that is known as trade cycle. There is some changes in income, employment, output. This circle is known as trade cycle. How we can describe this changes in the economy? Here we have to, on O axis we have to show the time, and O y axis we will show the output. This is our situation of full employment situation. This is the best situation in the economy, but in real life it is not possible that every time there is a full employment in the economy. The first situation we are taking here, boom. Boom, when there is the aggregate demand is greater than aggregate supply, then prices will be increased. This is a situation of boom. After the boom, there is a slow recession in the economy. Prices will be reduced in the economy. But if these prices are continuously down in the economy, this is known as depression. This is known as depression in the economy. This is known as depression in the economy if prices are continuously down in the economy. But after sometimes there will be a recovery in the economy. This resources are used properly and it will be recovered. And there will be a recovery, and after that there is a boom, depression. This process will be continued. This is a boom, this is a recession, this is a depression, and this is a recovery. This is known as trade cycle, because in the economy not full employment level is available at every time. This is our trade cycle. So there in our economy, boom, recession, depression, recovery, these things are possible in our trade cycle. Now this topic is finished. What is the meaning of excess demand? What is the meaning of deficit demand? What are the causes of excess demand? What are the causes of deficit demand? What will be the impact of excess demand and the deficit demand? Difference between the excess demand and deficit demand, and how we can correct the excess demand and deficit demand using the monetary policy and the fiscal policy, and this is our trade cycle.